Hi, I'm Chelsea, and this is Chelsea Cross Live. Why are adults scared of teenagers? Stay tuned, it's up next.
I want to target my generation, the millennials, but little did I know when I was starting the show, some of my biggest fans were going to be the grandparents and the parents of the teenagers.
Right now I'm in the Kibera slums, which are actually centered smack right in the middle of the city.
You have to love you because you are you, and that's it for life.
Unfortunately, girls today, they want everything fast. They want everything now. They want to be the best.
Food is not the enemy, and the gym doesn't need to be a chore. It's a lifestyle. I want you to open my book and feel like right away I'm talking to you. Giving back is something that I think everybody should do, and I think everybody understands once they get involved with a charity. I say it's a natural drug. It's like this high. I would have never been the spokesperson for You by Kotex if I wasn't involved with charity. And I had the amazing opportunity to interview the first Rwandan refugee to come to America. Her name was Christine Uwaizu. And she taught me more than any textbook can teach anyone. She taught me the gift of life. And after I met with her, we just had this amazing bond. And I looked at my mom, and I was like, Mom, we're going to Africa. Welcome back to Chelsea Cross Live. I'm here with my fabulous panel, and we're talking about something that we just can't escape. Drugs, pills, prescription drugs, alcohol. What's your take on legalizing marijuana, especially as a parent?
I'm mixed on that because when I grew up, it was everywhere. People who do smoke, they don't smoke out in the open like we did in the 70s. Did I say we?
I think the movie He's Just Not That Into You really nailed it on the head as to what technology has been doing within the dating and relationship world, especially for the girls, because sometimes we're so innocent and our hearts are so pure and we only want to seek the affection from the opposite sex, but technology kind of makes it hard for that one-on-one communication or that eye-to-eye contact because the boys are breaking up with us over text message or a BBM, or we're getting picked up by MySpace. We don't really understand in America how privileged we are to have hygiene products to be able to go on with our day-to-day lives. Kotex gave us all these thousands and thousands of feminine hygiene products to bring with us to Africa to hand deliver to the girls in the slums. So with the feminine hygiene product, a pad or a tampon, they're able to go to school. Lindsay makes me so upset because if I think that there is one teen train wreck that had so much talent and she could have done so much with the talent that she has and the ability that she was given, it was Lindsay. I mean, she was so talented. She was a singer, she was a dancer, she was an actress, she was beautiful. And she really let her talent go to waste. Nobody should be saying, I want to look like Angelina Jolie. No one should be saying, I want to look like Kate Hudson. It's because Kate Hudson looks like Kate Hudson. Angelina Jolie has those lips because she's Angelina Jolie. You have to love you. Boys are on the rise of eating disorders just as much as girls. I mean, they're coming up there, which is like very scary to know that it's hitting a lot of people. And I wanted to know, did any of you struggle with weight when you were younger to be able to talk about it now?
I struggled quite the opposite. I was severely underweight. And I know people would say, oh, I hate you for that. But really, I looked like I had cancer. And I would like eat junk constantly to try to fatten up.
Yeah, I would have hated you. So much goes into loving your body, and there's so many different subtopics you can talk about, like anorexia, bulimia, body dysmorphia, nutrition, fitness. Ever since I was a young teenager, I was definitely always struggling with my body. I never liked what I saw in the mirror. My nickname was Chipmunk. So I know what it feels like to not feel comfortable in your own skin.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Cross.
And I'm Christopher Grise, personal trainer.
We want to be the people that are going to motivate you to have a healthier and happier lifestyle. Exercise doesn't necessarily just mean what you see on the outside. It's so much more than that. It gets your endorphins pumping, it's a stress reliever, and there's no need for a fancy gym or equipment. All you need is your body and a little bit of room.
And a beautiful partner to work out with too.
Aww.
Teen pregnancy. Why are teen girls getting pregnant younger than ever? What's your take on adoption? Stay tuned.
Welcome back to Chelsea Cross Live. We were on the hot, controversial topic of teen pregnancy. More than ever, teenagers are getting pregnant at a very young age. But also, I think more than ever, they're starting to glamorize teen pregnancy. You would think that money or clothes or flip-flops would be really needed in Africa. What really is needed is for the women to go to school.
Well, sexting definitely seems to be the new and upcoming trend, and it doesn't matter what age you are, it seems to be something that's so easily accessible because everybody has their little cell phone attached to their hip. But unfortunately, sexting is becoming really popular amongst the elementary schools and middle schools and high schools. And what it is literally just taking naked pictures of yourself, which is basically free porn.
What's the number one cause of driving accidents today? We're all guilty of it. Texting and driving. Check out the number one blog at chelseacrosslive.com for safe driving tips.
There are a lot of teenagers out there who are noticed for the wrong reasons. But I wanted to start a platform for teenagers to be noticed for the right reasons and to be acknowledged for the happy and positive and motivational things that teenagers can do for teenagers. And that's what the open discussion and our voice, our opinion, our time to talk came in to Teen Talk Live. Before you met me, oh.